Hello and welcome to the Baptist Pulpit with Brother Ryan Goins, pastor of Way of the Cross Baptist Church in Dunlap, Tennessee. Now, if you feel the need to contact Brother Ryan, you can do so by emailing thebaptistpulpit@gmail.com. We hope you enjoy the message and that it's a help and a blessing to you.
John was a Baptist and I am a Baptist too.
Thank you once again for tuning in to the radio broadcast. Hope you're having a good day in the Lord. We'll start off with a good song from the church choir, and then we'll have a couple of specials from Highland Drive. Brother Dale Perry gave us permission to use their music on the radio, and so I appreciate that. And then we'll bring the first part of the message out of John chapter number 1 on becoming a child of God. And we pray it be a help and blessing to you. Hope you all have had a wonderful Thanksgiving as we enter in this holiday season. And hope you plan to make it to the Lord's house today.
Where the ransom will shine.
violently sweet. You're drifting too far from the shore. Drifting too far from the shore. You're drifting too far from the shore. Come to Jesus today. Let Him show you the way. You're drifting too far from the shore. Today the tempest rolls high, and clouds overshadow the sky. Sure death is hovering nigh. You're drifting too far from the shore. Drifting too far from the shore. You're drifting too far from the shore. Come to Jesus today. Let Him show you the way. You're drifting too far from the shore. Abundantly wait. Turn back before it's too late. You're drifting too far from the shore. Drifting too far from the shore. You're drifting too far from the shore. Come to Jesus today. Let Him show you the way. You're drifting too far from the shore.
Are paved with gold, where in peace I'll dwell forever. Oh, that joy can ne'er be told. Will you meet me over yonder, and with happy millions dwell? Will you meet me over yonder, where we'll ever say farewell?
Storms will pass forever, and we'll see.
snow. Will you meet me over yonder, and with happy millions dwell? Will you meet me over yonder, where we'll never say farewell?
Chapter number 1. We'll go ahead and we'll just start in verse number 1 and get to where we're going. Bible says, "In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by Him, and without Him was not anything made that was made. In Him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shineth in darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same was come for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. And he was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. And that was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. And he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came to his own, and his own received him not." Then verse number 12, where we want to bring the thrust of the message. He said, "But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor the will of the flesh, nor the will of man, but of God." In verse 14, it describes to us who this Word and this light is. "And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth." Lord, I pray you'll add your blessing to the Word of God. Lord, I pray that you'll touch us as we try to preach, that you'll be lifted up, and Lord, that your people be helped. And we thank you for it. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. I'll draw your attention to verse number 12, where it said, "But as many as received him, to them gave he power." And this is the phrase that's on my heart today: to become the sons of God. And if God will help me for a little while, I will preach on the thought of becoming a child of God. Becoming a child of God. As we look in the Word of God, we notice here in verse number 9 and 10, first thing I want to look at about Christ is the rejection of Jesus Christ. Verse number 9, notice what he says: "But that was the true light, which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not." We find that he was rejected by the world. He was rejected by the world, by the governments of the world. The Lord Jesus Christ was rejected, not only by the governments of the world, but also by just the, in general, around the world, Jesus Christ, by the heathen, have been rejected. That's what he tells us in the book of Romans, how they took the image of God, they took and conformed God in the image of corruptible man and corruptible beast and birds and fowls and creeping things and all those different things you find in the book of Romans chapter number 1, you'll find that Jesus Christ was rejected by the heathen. As we look at the Word of God, we notice that Jesus was rejected by the heathen. Not only was he rejected by the heathen, but he was rejected by his kindred, by his brothers. Look what he said in verse number 10, and he was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. The very ones he made, this world rejected him. But in verse number 11, he came unto his own, and his own received him not. He was rejected by the world. Not only was he rejected by the world, but he was rejected by the Jews, his chosen people. If there's anybody that should have come to Jesus Christ, it was
was the people of God, the people of Israel. They had only seen for thousands of years and hundreds of years the sacrifices being types of Jesus Christ. And they had only, the only people on earth that had the word from God and had the promises by God given directly to them, chosen out of all the people of the world, blessed above all the people of the world, used by God to bring the world's greatest blessing that ever has been, ever will be. God used His people, yet they rejected Jesus Christ. They crucified Him upon the cross. They delivered Him to the world governments, and the world governments rejected Him. All men rejected Jesus Christ. And you'll find, as you study out history and the Word of God, you'll find that most men do reject Jesus Christ. Most men turn away from God. And I want to leave this with you and beg you today, do not reject Jesus Christ. We see not only the rejection of Christ, but there's the receiving of Christ. In verse number 11, notice what he said. He came into his own received him not, but as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name. We see the presentation or the preaching of Jesus Christ to all men. He said, as many as received him. We see in verse number 7, look at what your Bible said. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. All men. God wanted all men everywhere to believe on Jesus Christ. Look at what he said in verse number 9. That was the true light which lighteth every man that cometh into the world. He tells us later on in the epistles, I think it's 1 Peter, he said this, Brother Dustin, God is not willing that any should perish, but that all should come in repentance. There's not just a select few that's going to heaven and all the rest of the world going to hell. I understand that there is a few that believed on him, but they called upon him in faith and trust and placed their trust in Jesus Christ. There's no man predestined, preordained to go to hell and suffer for all eternity. God died for all men. He tasted death for every man. He is the propitiation for our sins, and not for our sins only, but the sins of the whole world. I've tried to talk to them and try to figure out. I told them Calvinists, Brother Brent, I said, man, how do you get around them verses? They said, well, that's the whole saved world. Well, you got to add to the Word of God, and you got to take from the Word of God. Jesus Christ died for all men. He shed His blood that all men might be saved. He wants every man, woman, boy, and girl to be born again before it's everlasting too late. We see the receiving of Christ, the presentation to all men, as many. He said, for whosoever will. That's the ones getting in, is whosoever will. If you'll come to him, he said, if any man cometh to me, I will in no wise cast out. There's no man, woman, boy, or girl ever came to Jesus Christ and said, Lord, I trust you to get me to heaven. God, I repent of my sin. I repent of what I am. And I ask you in faith and trust to save my soul. There's no one of them ever been turned away. We see the receiving of Christ, the presentation. I'm feeling pretty good, Brother Daggett. The presentation, preaching to all men, as many. In verse number 12, he said, but as many as received him, to them gave he power. Not only do we see the presentation to all men, but we see the power of God. To them gave he power to become the sons of God. I have no ability in myself to be born again. We'll get in that a little bit further in just a moment. But while I'm here, I'll go ahead and say it. There's nothing you, me, or anyone can do in the ways of works, in the ways of heritage, in the ways of generosity. There's nothing we can do to earn salvation. It is a gift of God. The wages of sin is death. You'll work for your salvation. Go ahead and try. But the wages of sin is death. But the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. I'm thankful it is a gift that's presented to you and I. We see the presentation and preaching to all men the power of God. Unto them gave he power to become the sons of God. How did he do that? How do you give them power to be the sons of God? Well, in the book of Romans, he said, "For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek." God sent a preacher. God sent a book. God sent a witness to give power to lost and dying men to call on God and be saved. He chose the foolishness of preaching. That's why we preach. That's why we send missionaries. That's why we pass out gospel tracts. That's why we have our Bibles and print Bibles and pass out Bibles. That's why we spread the word. Because it is the power of God unto salvation. I mean, you can get saved during the singing, I know that. But man, I've heard a lot of good singing, but that singing normally don't convict me like that Bible does. He didn't say, I know I say this all the time. He didn't say he chose the beauty of singing or the intellect of teaching. He didn't say he used the talents. He didn't say he chose any of the wealth. He said God chose the foolishness of preaching. Paul said, I didn't come to you with any great enticing words. He said, I didn't try to impress you with my vocabulary or my oratory skills. He said, I saved to know nothing about you except Jesus Christ and Him crucified. He said, not only did I not come to you with enticing words of men's wisdom, but he said, Brother Tom, he said, I didn't even go dig up every skeleton in your closet. I didn't even go back and ask all your loved ones about you. He said, I chose not to know nothing about you, and I just got up and preached the Word of God and let the Word of God does what He wants to do. Why? Because the preaching of the cross is them that perish foolishness, but unto us that are saved, it is the power of God unto salvation. There's something about preaching just thrills my soul. There's something about preaching, unless you mate, that just stirs up in my heart and does something to me. I'd hate to think, and I'm not griping at nobody. Don't think that. The Lord does what He wants to do, and I'm not griping at nobody today. But I'd hate to think that I'd be in the house of God and the singing would excite my soul. And the preaching of the blessed Word of God kind of put a cold towel on what the Lord had done in my heart. I'm not griping at nobody. I'm just talking about in general. I've been there before. Now, I've been there sometimes, and it's the preacher's fault. I've been the one preaching sometimes, and it'd be the preacher's fault. We see the rejection of Christ, the receiving of Christ. There's the presentation and the preaching to all men. There's the power of God. He gave them the power to be born again. But then we see the promise of faith. We see the promise of faith. He said, but as many as received Him, to them gave He power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on His name. See, not only did God give me the Word so I knew what to believe, and this is where some will fall out with me, and that's okay, but God gave me the faith that I might believe. Amen. How did He do that? Through the Word. Amen. He said, faith cometh by hearing. And hearing by the what? The Word of God. You want faith, saving faith. You want your children to be born again and get saved at a young age. I'm not not saying it'll guarantee you that it'll happen, that they got a better shot than if you don't. Read the Word of God to them. Take them to Sunday school. Drag them in every time the doors is open. Keep them under the preaching of the Word. Why? Because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. You're discouraged in your heart. Don't know what to do. Don't know where to go. Get in the house of God. Get in the Word of God. When it's hard, stick with it. When it's hard and it's painful, stick with it. Stay in there. Because faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the Word of God. We see the power of God is given to them, but the promise of faith. He said, but as many as received Him, to them gave He power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on His name. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Boy, I'm glad it's that easy. I'm glad salvation isn't complicated. I'm glad it's not hard. I'm glad you don't have to be smart to get saved. I wouldn't make it. I'm glad you don't have to be rich to get saved. I wouldn't make it. I'm glad you ain't even got to be good to be saved. Because I wouldn't make it. But he said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give ye rest.
You've been listening to The Baptist Pulpit with Brother Ryan Goins, pastor of Way of the Cross Baptist Church in Dunlap, Tennessee. Feel free to email thebaptistpulpit@gmail.com.